Alright guys, Futurism here again, doing another Call of Duty commentary. Today I'm going to be touching on what games mean to me and really where games came from for me. I've been playing games, well, computer games I suppose, since I was like 5, 6 years old, and I'm 24 now, so it's quite a way, you know, like 18 years. And they've changed a lot, just how games are made up. Like back in the day, I wrote a few games down. Like I started off on Quake on the PC, all first person shooters, of course, Unreal Tournament, Medal of Honor, Soldier of Fortune, Half-Life, COD 1. And around Call of Duty 1 is where games started to change for me, because that's where I started to play games online. And so when multiplayer really started, I remember getting 512k broadband, and that allowed me to go online and start really sampling a new type of gaming in my eyes. Because before that, all gaming was to me was a storyline. I didn't really read books and didn't really watch much telly back then days. It wasn't Netflix and stuff, yeah, no. And there wasn't YouTube and all this other thing. It was four channels on the telly. So I used to get sort of my adventure, I suppose, as a child from playing games and stuff like Tomb Raider and Half-Life. But the storylines you sort of got involved in, you know, like people who played Halo especially, you know, you sort of become one with the character and you're making them decisions, and it's a lot more personal. And when I started to play Call of Duty Online, it was a repetitive task, as you can imagine. It's team deathmatch, that kind of thing. And it's what I got from Unreal Tournament. So I had played it similarly before, where, you know, it was a repetitive process, but it was with other people for the first time, and you've got this community all of a sudden. And I'll be honest, there wasn't all the mics and stuff you had now, and it was, you were all typing in a chat box, and really there was very little communication. Everyone was just there to sort of try out this new idea of playing online, I suppose. That then progressed for me to with the release of Half-Life 2. You obviously got Counter-Strike Source, and that was really worth it. That had no storyline, that was just go on and play online. And I really sort of found my home in that game, and I really enjoyed it. I like the idea of the objective base of the game. You know, it's pretty much search and destroy all the time, and it made me play as more of a player, I think. And I like the challenging side of it. It was beating your opponent, and you weren't outwitting a computer. At the end of the day, when you're playing the game, the programmer or the developer who made the game has designed it for you to do it in a certain way, and if you do it that way, you're going to win the game. Whereas if you're playing against another person, I always talk about it like playing chess. It's like game theory. You're trying to outwit them. You might not necessarily be the best shot, but you can still beat the opposition. And if you can play the game better. And really, really started the team-based game playing, I noticed, especially because on Counter-Strike, it's almost essential. And I started playing in clans and stuff, and that community side of it came out. I then progressed onto, say, Xbox 360 and, obviously, COD 4, because that's pretty much the first game I picked up. And ever since then, I was sort of hooked. It took me a while to get used to it, because obviously I used to play mouse and keyboard before, and you're getting over to a controller, and it was almost like backwards technology. You were like, why would I restrict myself with two analog sticks when I can just point and click? But I think there was more of the community there, and that's what I want to get onto with multiplayer. Because there was people playing it, and there was a lot more people to play against, and there's a lot more people of different skill base, you find, because that's one of the things I noticed a lot on it. On PC, you're either amazing or terrible, whereas on Xbox, I find it can change dramatically, like on console, sorry, you can really change, have a spectrum of abilities. And that was when I really noticed that I didn't really care at all for storylines. I did play Call of Duty 4 storyline, and I didn't even bother with World at War, because I was so hooked with the multiplayer from COD 4. I then swapped to Modern Warfare 2 as the community moved. And the point I suppose I'm trying to get towards at the end of all this is that, is what makes a good game now what the game is designed, or is what makes a good game now where the community is based? Because if there was no one playing Call of Duty 4, or Call of Duty, sorry, not COD, and everyone was playing Battlefield, then there would be no game to play on Call of Duty. And I know that's almost like alien to think, because it's like the standard game, and it's sort of the standard platform. If everyone only played Battlefield, then there'd be no game. Like, that's what happened with Titanfall. Like, it came out, it had a spree in the market, but because there was no other reason to return to it other than the multiplayer, and when there wasn't really many people playing it, and what you're essentially doing is there's no challenge there for anyone, because you become a certain level in the game, and there's no one better than you. Whereas with Call of Duty, because it's been going for so many years, like COD 4, I didn't even know the release date, it must be 2007. It's, you know, you've got people who've been practicing and honing their skills for all this time, and I know you can't tramp, it's not the same game every time you've swapped, and that's shown especially with Advanced Warfare, which is why I think it didn't do as well in multiple, like people haven't enjoyed it as much because they can't transfer them skills from the previous one. So you are sort of starting like handicapped in the game because you aren't being able to transfer as many of your skills from the previous cards. And I think that's why it hasn't done as well. But I think that also means that is there going to be any chance for another game in the mod? Because if we're all going to stick to our franchise that is Call of Duty or all the things, or all those games that you specifically play, will any other game really get a chance at being that leader and taking sort of the bulk of the multiplayer players and having them all in that one game? Because that's how they would be saved. That's how you, I suppose you're only going to become now the top game in the field. I've talked a lot about playing a game and the competitive side, and how I said that the community-based and multiplayer side of games really drives you to want to be the best, I suppose. I want to steer back towards what makes a game fun, because as a child, I suppose I had my PC, and that's where I played games, but I also used to have a Game Boy, and I suppose that's where I used to get the fun side, and almost like the storyline-based things back again. But it was the fun, like the enjoyment, like the excitement, the having a laugh. And then I remember having a GameCube, and that was for the same reasons. Like, I wasn't playing them games to win. And I remember the first time I played Amnesia, and this sort of, this statement sort of stuck me with the game. And I suppose you're not playing Amnesia for fun. And it said to me at the beginning, don't play this game to win, play it for an experience. And ever since that moment when I'm playing a game that basically isn't multiplayer based, I'm trying to get the experience that the developer wanted to give to me. And with Call of Duty, that's quite, I suppose that's where you get your storyline from, and you settle in, you get your headset on, and you get in the moment. But what I'm doing on this game here, I'm playing a bit of Call of Duty. I haven't really talked about what I'm doing so far, but Call of Duty Ghosts, it's hated by the community, but I was having fun on it again. And you can see I'm running my throwing knives, and I've got my pistol out, and I'm playing Strike Zone 24/7 because it's probably the easiest map for this kind of game to have. But I was enjoying myself, and I think so much of the community is based around like KD and how good you are as a player, and I think that really removes the fun aspect from Call of Duty. And I'm not saying you can't have fun in it, and it's very easy to get a group of guys together, and I suppose the community makes it fun, but as an individual player, I still think we need to grasp on them fun moments and stop getting so angry when we play games. I'm always raging, I can't be the worst person to talk about it, but I really do think that we need to play games for enjoyment rather than playing the games to be the best. I'm going to call it there. I think that's a nice place to end it. But thanks for listening. If you do enjoy it, please share the video around and drop me a subscribe. This is Futurism, signing off.